Hey, third graders, it is Mrs. Lakos again with another economics lesson. Needs, wants, scarcity, choice, and opportunity cost. The learning target is being able to explain why scarcity leads to choice. And it's important because this kind of reasoning goes along with most of the choices that we make. And you know you have it when you get four or five correct answers on the quiz. So we all have things we need and things we want, but we can't get everything. There is a scarcity of money. That simply means there is not enough money for it all. There's a limited amount of money that we have. And first, that money needs to go to the needs. We need clothing. We need food. We can choose which foods, but we need to satisfy those needs. Then you get to the wants. You really need to make sure you have shoes before you have a bike. You need to make sure you have a shelter before you get a chocolate sundae. And there is scarcity of money, which leads to choices. Now, sometimes there's choices just in our wants as well. This boy's deciding if he wants the lollipop or if he should save his money for something later, like a new video game. If he chooses to save for the game, he loses the lollipop. That is his opportunity cost. That's what it cost him to make that choice to wait to spend his money. People or companies that produce goods are called producers, and the consumers are people like you and me who buy the goods. So there's a bakery, the producers are the bakers, and all these other store shelves are products made by goods made by producers. And when we go shopping, we are the consumers. So the producers also have choices and opportunity cost because of scarcity. So let's say that you and I open a sweet shop selling all these treats that, you know, we're also going to gain weight because they all look good and we want to snack. But we make a lot of money because so many people are visiting our store. These coconut macaroons are the best seller. That's what we sell the most of. So your job at the sweet shop is to set out the displays and help with the baking and the cleanup. And we hired a baker to do the oven stuff and keep track of all the ingredients. Well, one day the baker tells us that the coconut delivery is delayed for a month. So now we have to make a choice. Because there is scarcity, there is not enough coconut, we're going to make two choices. We have two choices. We can do nothing, wait for the coconut, and we won't make any money though because we can't sell the macaroons. The other choice is getting coconut from somewhere else and keep making the cookies. But that coconut cost us more money. So if we go with choice one and stop making the coconut macaroons, our opportunity cost is the customers who may not come to our store. We might have an empty store. But if we go with choice two and get different coconut, our opportunity cost is the extra money we have to spend to keep making the cookies. Neither choice is great, but that happens sometimes when there is a scarcity of resources. Which one would you choose? Go ahead and take the quiz.